Hello everybody, greetings from Turkey. My name is Meriç and I'm a mechanical engineer. Today we are going to learn how to calculate flexural stiffness, which is also known D value, in composite plates. And we are going to learn why this D value is important and how we can use it in the calculations. So first of all, let's start with laminated composite plates. They are created by laminas, and these laminas can be oriented in the different directions. For example, in the 90 degrees, they can be in the 0 degrees or 45 degrees. And so if we stack them, we can have a laminated composite plate. So before we calculate the D value, we need to define material properties. And after that, we can calculate the Q values. And then we can calculate the Q bar values according to the all angles and the all ply, and after that finally we can calculate D values and we can have the D matrix as shown here. So we are going to have some assumptions. First of all, we are going to use classical plate theory, and that means there is no thickness, and we are going to neglect transverse shear deformation effects. So that means there is no 1/6 and 2/6 terms. So these terms will be zero. So let's continue with the material properties. So as you know that composite materials have different material properties in the different directions. So we have elastic modulus in the 1/1 direction, which is shown here, and elastic modulus in the 2/2 direction. And also we have Poisson ratio in the 1/2 direction, which is shown here as 0.27. And we are going to calculate Poisson ratio in the 2/1 direction according to this formulation. And the Poisson ratio in the 2/1 direction is found here. So we have G value G12 in the 1/2 direction, which is shown here. So we have 4 ply in the laminated composite plate. So our stacking sequence will be 0, 90, 90, 0, which is shown here, and each ply will be 2.5 millimeter thick. And after we stack the plies, we are going to have 10 millimeter thick plate at all. So let's start with the calculation of Q values. Q11 is equal to E11 divided by 1 minus Poisson ratios. So we are going to use E11 and the Poisson ratios, and Q11 is calculated here. So we need to calculate the all values in the in these directions, because we need to know that to calculate the D values. So Q22 should be calculated according to this formulation, and this is the E22, and Q22 is here. Q12 should be calculated this formulation, and Poisson ratio is here, elastic modulus is here. So we have Q12 is here, and also Q12 is equal to Q21. So Q66 is equal to G12. So Q66 is here. So after that, we are going to calculate Q bar. But before we go to the Q bar, we need to remember the stacking sequence, which will be used in the Q bar calculation. And there will be some M and N value. M means cosine theta and N means sine theta. And these values will be calculated for the each ply and each angle. So for the 90 degrees plies, M will be 0 and N will be 1. For the 0 degrees angle ply, M will be 1 and N will be 0. So for the 0 angle, we are going to take M is equal to 1 and N is equal to 0. So to calculate the Q bar 1/1 value, we are going to use this formulation. And here M is 1, N is 0. So this is going to be 0, and this is also going to be 0. And I'm sorry. Okay. So that will be 0 and these values will be 0 and q bar 11 is equal to that value. So if we continue with the q bar 12, m is 1 and n is 0. So this term is 0 according to the n and that is 0. The only left is this value. So q bar 12 will be that value. And q bar 12 is equal to also q bar 21, so they have same value. So q bar 22 is equal to that formulation. So n is equal to 0. So these two values are gone, and the only left is q 22 here, and we have just this value. So for the q bar 66, we are going to this formulation, and that will be 0 according to the n, n is 0, and that will be 0. The only left is here, and q bar 66 is here. These are all for the 0 angle, and we need to make this calculation for the 90 degrees, and then we can find the values. So for 90 degrees calculations, m will be 0 and n will be 1. So we are going to use same formulations, but the m and n will be changed. So this is gone and this is gone according to the m is 0. And the on left is q22. So q bar 11 is equal to this value. So for 90 degrees, so m is 0, this value is 0, and that is 0. The only left is q12, so q bar 12 is equal to this value, and the m is 0 and all of them is gone, and this is gone. So we have only just this value, and q22 bar is here. So for the 90 degrees and q bar 66 is here, and for m equal to 0 that will be gone, and that will be gone. The only left is q bar 66 is here, all of them is gone, is here. So to calculate the d value, we are going to use q bar 1, q bar values I mean. So we are going to calculate the d values according to the ply and the thickness. So for example, if we are going to calculate d11, we need to consider the each lamina. This is the first lamina, this is the second, this is the third, and this is the fourth lamina. So in the first lamina, we need to consider q bar 110, because the first lamina have 0 degrees angle, and the second lamina we need to consider q bar 11 in the 90 angle, which is shown here. So third lamina we need to consider 90 degrees q bar 11, and which is here, and the fourth lamina, and which is here, q bar 110 should be considered. And for the notation, this h is the thickness, and it should be started from the bottom as a 0, which is h0, and also the middle plane should be considered as the 0 thickness, in the coordinate system, which will be 0. These are the minus values, so there is a mistake, that will be minus 0.005 meter. So these are the positive values. So let me erase them. Okay, so let's make an example about that. So before we go to the example, I need to make it clear. So in the H1, which we are going to use this value, and the H0 we are going to use this value as a minus. So for the D11, we are going to use this formulation, and this is the H1 and this is the H0. They are in the minus sign. So this belongs to first layer, and that belongs to second layer. So that belongs to third layer, and that belongs to fourth layer. We are going to sum all them up, and we are going to use D11 as a 3.28 kilonewton times meter. So we are going to make this calculation for the D12, and we are going to use Q bar 12 at this time, because they are related with the D12. So that is for the first layer, and that is for the second layer, for the third layer, and for the fourth layer. So we are going to use same thickness value, you can see, because we have same thickness in the each ply. So we have D12 as a this value, so D21 will be the same value with the D12. So for the D22 we are going to use Q bar 22. So as you know, that the thickness is the same, thickness difference is the same, but the Q bar 22 is different. For the first layer with zero angle, and the second layer with 90 degrees, and the third layer with 90 degrees, and the fourth layer with 0 degrees, and D22 is 1.11 kilonewton times meter. So let's continue with the D66, and at this time we are going to use Q bar 66, and the thickness difference is the same every time. So this is for the first layer and the second layer, for the third layer and the fourth layer. So D66 value is shown here. So we learned all of the D values which is shown in the beginning. So we can create the D matrix according to our assumptions, because some of the 1.6 and 2.6 values will be zero. So okay, the D16 and D26 values will be zero. They are here, and I'm going to copy the D values here, and that is our D matrix, flexural stiffness matrix, which will be used in the calculations. So we need to calculate the D1, D2 and D3 values to calculate buckling load, bending load, or even in the natural frequency. So D1 is equal to D11. So D2 is equal to D22, and D3 is different than the others, because we need to sum two terms here. So where we can use these D values, let me show you an example. To calculate the buckling load for all ages our simply supported plate, laminated composite plate, we can use this formulation. And as you can see, the only value that we don't know is D values, D1, D3 and D2 values. If we learn them, we can calculate the buckling values according to the geometry and the mode. So in the natural frequency, we can calculate this natural frequency for the all ages are simply supported composite laminated plate. We can use again this D values, and if we know the density and the thickness, we can calculate the natural frequency according to the D value. So this is very important in the calculations, in the buckling, in the vibration, in the bending. We are going to use this value. And in the next tutorial, we are going to calculate the buckling load according to the D values, and we are going to analyze it in the ANSYS, and we are going to validate our results. So see you in the next tutorial. Have a nice day. Thank you for watching.